First 1 minute of trading, and I'm concentrating on two big movers, LL here on the left and Sharpe here on the right. Now, LL is 20% down, but started moving down, so that's not a good sign for me. I always need to see them moving up first. So look at Sharpe here, which is moving up. Stock is down approximately 7%. Now it's coming up. That means buyers are buying, and soon they will discover that the price will come down because that's what they usually do, and I'm getting ready to short. These are 1 minute candles, and here we go. I'm short, Sharpe, 4,000 shares. It is a bit spready, like 40 cents, maybe more, and here she comes. Okay, that's an initial nice move. Shorted it at 138.54. Almost a dollar now, more than a dollar now. Oh, she's going. Okay, she's going. I'm getting ready for a partial at any pullback now. I don't want to see any pullback. If she moves over 137.50 now, oh, great, look. 2 points, and she's going, come to papa, come to papa. Yes, continue. I'm getting ready at any pullback. 2 points by now. I don't want to see any pullback. Watch the sellers at all time. The pullback is going to come here. Look at the numbers coming down. Look at the sellers dropping down. Look at them selling here. And can we continue? Still holding. And now 136, sellers just moved down to 136, 2.5 points, getting ready to cover at any pullback. Look at the sellers coming down. If you look for a pullback, you always look at the seller's side. We just moved under, good, here come 3 points. Pullback, look, sellers just moved up 30 cents. It's not a good sign. It's not a good sign. Can we see a new low? No, they're moving up now. Watch the sellers. The sellers were down at 135.50. They moved up to 136, and then they moved up to 136.20. That's the first pullback. Now take a good look at the chart. Maybe I've done a mistake here. I don't know. So far, it looks like it's coming even lower, but I think that should be the bottom here. It's probably going to pull back from here. What an amazing first trade. First 5 minutes of the trading day, and look right here at the result. This is just absolutely amazing. Start my day up $9,000. Now let's go back to the trade. Let's talk a little bit about what happened here. Stock gapped down more than 6%. Initial move was up. That's the first 1 minute candle. You always want to see the buyers moving out of the game. So why would they buy at all? A stock that is gapping down 6%? Because they are averaging down their losses, because they think they've got themselves a great deal, because they think they're probably going to make a lot of money from the stock coming up. Well, they may be right, they may be wrong. Usually they're wrong. So when a stock is gapping down and then moving up, that means the buyers are buying. And I want to see them getting out of the game. I want to see them pulling out of the game, meaning I want to see the buyers behind us. I want to see the sellers taking over. And the sellers will usually take over. So if the stock is coming up initially, that's great. It means the buyers are buying. And soon, there's only going to be left sellers. Now, is that right 100% of the time? Absolutely not. But is it right more than 50% of the time? Well, more like 70% of the time. So that's how I make my money. I'm looking for stocks that are gapping down, initially moving up. It doesn't always have to be the first 1 minute candle, just like you've seen here. But then initially coming up, buyers are out of the game. Then it reverses. The second 1 minute candle was the reversal sign, and then you short it. Now, did I take my partial at the right time? As you can see here, not quite. But that was a great trade anyway. I'm very happy to have this one as my first trade today. And here comes LL. As you remember, LL started by moving down, so I didn't really have a chance to short it earlier. But now that it came up, I'm about to short 2,000 shares. Anything I do now, after my first good trade, amazing trade, is small size. Because I never ever take a risk. One of the biggest mistakes you may do when you're trading is take the risk with regular size at your second, third, and whatever next trades. I always lower my size. The reason I lower my size is because I feel invincible now. I'm up $9,000. I really do feel invincible. And that is a dangerous feeling in trading. There's two different occasions where you should lower your size dramatically. One is when you're up for the day, dramatically up, like I am right now, getting ready for my partial here. And the second one, took my partial now. It was a very quick in and out trade, as you can see. And the second one is when you're down dramatically. So when you're down dramatically, you should lower your size too, because then you're trying to get back to green territory. So I just had two nice trades here, and I hope to continue this way. But anything I do from now on is going to be small size. LRCX is looking great for long. The trend is amazing. Nice reversal point. Stop should be somewhere around here, 194.40. I'm going long right now. Again, small size, hoping to see it over the high soon. And again, a very nice trend. Stock up 4%. That means everybody's watching it. I'm a little bit concerned about market direction, but LRCX really does look good. I like Caterpillar. It's getting close to the 142.50 mark. That's a nice breakout point. Stock is up 2%. Very well-known company. People love to buy it when... Okay, just moved. I'm buying. I'm long. Caterpillar. I like MS. There's a nice resistance point here at the highs. $40, whole number. You usually find a lot of sellers at whole numbers. I'm going to buy once it moves over the whole number now. I'm long. Okay, I'm looking for some continuation. My target is 40.25. My stop is also approximately 25 cents. It's a nice breakout formation, and I hope I'm going to see it real quick at my target. Makes a nice initial move here. LL is returning to the $20 mark. I would like to see it moving under the $20 mark and then short it once more. Now, I already had... Here we go. I'm short. I already had a failing short earlier. I shorted it here, failed. As you can see, it moved up. It was an unpleasant loss. My first trade in LL today was a nice winner, small winner. And now it's coming down a little bit. Well, you're probably wondering how I'm doing till now. Well, here's the end result. As you can see, I'm having a terrible day. My first trade was amazing, up $9,000. But then look at the rest. Look how much money I lost. If you remember, my first trade in LL was a nice green trade, but I managed to short another one later and then another one. And well, the end result is up $2,000, but I did start my day up with $9,000. And the only thing I did throughout the day was just losing it. That's it. I was just losing everything I made today, almost everything. I am left green, $2,000. Am I happy? I hate myself today. Now, I want to go back to what I mentioned when we started this video today. When I started my day up $9,000, I understood immediately, although I did not feel that way, that I'm not really capable of just having a regular trading day anymore. It is impossible, once you have such a big winner, to feel just like every regular day. I was feeling invincible. I knew I had to lower my size. I took every trade I saw, I thought they looked great, probably because I felt invincible. That's why you need to lower your size when you're feeling that way. There's, again, two occasions where you need to lower your size. One is when you're doing great. The second one is when you're having a terrible day. I was doing great. I need to lower my size. Look at LL here. It's crazy. I started with a green trade in LL and then another two or three. I can't remember how many trades I had there when I continued losing money. I started with $9,000 today, but I finished only with $2,000. And that's really crazy. That shouldn't have happened. And since I know that I'm just a human being, I have a rule. I'm lowering my size. I don't trade the same size if I'm down too much or up too much. Years ago, when I used to have the same kind of trades, just like now, being green for the day, I used to continue trading just like a regular day, and the end result would usually be giving back all my winnings and even getting into deep red territory. That no longer happens to me. I'm lowering my size. I'm trying to hold as much as I can to my profits. I didn't quite manage to do that today. I'm still proud at finishing this day green up $2,000. That was a terrible day because I only enjoyed the first 5 minutes. And then it all went down the drain, or most of it. So what I want you to remember from this video is that you need to lower your size in two different occasions, when you're up dramatically or when you're down dramatically. Don't think you're invincible. On the other hand, if you're losing money, don't try to get back to green. That could be one of your worst days ever. So just hold on to your money if you're up. Hold on to your loss if you're down. Just continue trading, but with very low size. I lowered my size by, I believe, 3/4 or so. And that's what kept me green for the day.
Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its Trading Room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.